Melanie Anderson epitomizes the optimism of finding a better way. The process where someone, when presented with a problem, chooses to create the solution rather than work around it. This episode of Dare to Invent is in memory of Melanie Anderson and the success of her idea.
Melanie was born in Chicago, Illinois. She was an on-again, off-again kind of baker. She baked only when the moment struck her. One day when making brownies, she thought, there has to be a better way to quickly and cleanly cut all these brownies to the same size.
When Melanie came to us, she had already spent a ton of money on a patent of her idea. No one knew yet if her product was something that a manufacturer could make at an affordable price, or even if a company would want something like her idea as part of their product line. In other words, she put the cart before the horse.
The project was given to Nathan. He's a good hand to have in the kitchen, and he enjoys the occasional baked good.
Melanie's idea was an object that would be used to cut a whole tray of brownies at one time by pressing it into the pan. She called it the Easy Cutter Baking Divider. All we needed to do was to build it and then test it.
While Nathan was building Melanie's product, we decided to have Clay test different cutting methods. We gave him 5 pans of brownies and, access to power tools.
Test this.
How do you think this works?
Well, it appears to be designed to quickly divide brownies into 36 perfect 1.5-inch cubes.
So, small squares.
I prefer quickly and easily subdivide 1.5-inch
cubes. Yeah, okay, let's just try it.
Well, that seemed to be efficient and effective.
It worked, just like we knew it would. Now it's time for Dan to work his magic and get that product licensed.
So I pitched the product to a housewares company, and at first, they weren't interested in it. However, they did provide some excellent feedback.
Brownies were out, and cupcakes were in. Mm-hmm.
I brought the information back to Nathan and the client so we could discuss next steps. And that's when I found out that Melanie was sick.
Melanie was battling cancer.
At the pitch meeting, they realized that Melanie was onto something, but wanted to take it in a different direction.
We thought about the feedback we were getting and got an idea for something new. We went to work.
We kept a divider, added a custom pan, poured in different batters for hundreds of flavor combinations, and switched the whole idea for cupcakes.
Voila, we invented the world's first half and half cupcake pan for Melanie. Totally awesome, totally cool, and totally simple to make.
I brought the revamped product in for another pitch. They loved it. Mrs. Fields planned to manufacture and sell it right away.
By the time it was manufactured and on the store shelves, Melanie had passed. We invited her brother, Richard, to Invention Land to discuss her success. Meeting off today with a bit of a surprise. This was what we were working on for your sister.
Okay.
And we're excited to show you today. So you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Holy cow. Wow. Well, this
is
incredible.
I'm glad you like it, Richard.
Oh, I love it.
I wish your sister was here with us today.
Yeah, I do too.
I showed Richard around Invention Land. And I had a little something extra in store for him.
That's right. Well, I thought what we could do is end the tour today by coming over to the concept kitchen.
Okay.
Mostly because your sister's invention started
in the kitchen. Right.
So we have a surprise plan for you.
Ooh, and surprises are good.
You like surprises?
Well, yeah.
Well, if you'll trust me.
Okay.
And you'll keep your eyes closed, I'll lead you in here then.
Okay.
All right. And are you ready?
I'm ready.
Open your eyes.
Ho, ho, ho!
That's your first royalty check. We also have this surprise.
We're gonna be giving 1% of all the gross proceeds to cancer research.
Excellent.
In the name of your sister.
Excellent.
But since this is the half and half cupcake pan, I only gave you half the check. Here's the other half. So you can put both those together, and that's your first royalty check.
My goodness sakes.
Congratulations.
What she left behind was her legacy. You know, that she may be gone, but she has left something for the world that is her. It would be a highlight of her life. It just really makes me sad that she's not the one that gets it.
This is the half and half nonstick cupcake pan, and it's really, really unique.
How about a fun twist on an old favorite?
Yeah, it's brand new today for Mrs. Fields.
We love it.
I love it too.
We love it.